Welcome to your site selection tutorial video using the PersonaLive segmentation system. We've got six videos where we will walk you through how to discover your best target segments, how to use them for site selection, product assortment, sales forecasting. We'll look at the other side of the table with leasing strategy and tenant representation, and we'll finish up with property acquisition. I recommend everybody read or listen to the first one, part one, discover target segments. And the rest of them, you can pick out what seems interested in you and you can just skip to that section. Okay, so what we're gonna be going through today in this overview video is the data landscape, our two data sets, PersonaLive and Proximity, differences between them, the data sources that flow into them, when you would use each, and we'll finish up with segment hierarchy. It's always really helpful to stop and think about where Geosocial fits into our site selection toolkit. The beginning of any good site selection strategy starts with census data, which is a study of people based on their demographics. You also have psychographic data, which is a study of people based on where they live, and it groups people of similar demographics and applies survey data to understand what they're interested in. But you might have two people that have the same exact demographics, same age, same income, but they're interested in two totally different things. And this is where the opportunity comes in for the study of people based on what they do. So there's been a few innovations that have happened since the 1970s that allows us to understand behavior at scale without the use of surveys. The first is GPS, and that ties something that's happening in the digital space down to a location. The second is our mobile phones, which allows us to understand retail visitation. And the third is social media, where you have billions of people that are sharing mindsets, interests, and attitudes. And think of that as an organic survey that's always running that has billions of people contributing to it. So the geosocial is a study of people based on what they do. So we're clustering people based on their actual actions rather than just demographics alone. So this tutorial is going to be about our PersonaLive segmentation system, but it's worth mentioning our proximity data set as well, because they work together really nicely. And we'll talk about what's different between them. The proximity data set is a segmentation of places. It classifies block groups based on what people are doing and what is being geotagged in those block groups. And the data comes from where that post was tagged. Whereas the PersonaLive segmentation system is a segmentation of people, and it classifies households based on social media, mobile behavior, web visitation, and demographic attributes. It comes from the home block group of the poster. So we're taking all the geotagged information and then tracking that back in an anonymous way to the home block group. It's always really helpful to see these on the map to understand the difference. So the proximity data set, what does it answer? It answers what behaviors are happening in proximity to my location. So you want to keep a really tight trade area there. You can think of it as a site characteristic. It measures the behavior in a percentile score 0 to 100, how much yoga behavior is happening here. The PersonaLive, which segments people, answers the question, who are the people living in my trade area? So now you can use a wider trade area. It measures households and measures counts, so 0 to however many people are in that trade area or however many households, and it is a population characteristic. The proximity data set, the sources going into it are basically Facebook, Flickr, Foursquare, Instagram, Twitter. This is mainly Instagram and Twitter posts just because that is the most frequent, it's the most public data source, and it's also the most geotagged. Remember, this is where that post was tagged. And it's not hierarchical, so you can't really group up behaviors. Each behavior is sort of individual and by itself. The persona segmentation system tracks all the back social media back to the home block groups, and it also clusters people based on their mobile visitation, what types of high-end retail, discount retail, independent retail they're visiting. 200 desktop devices, we're looking at website visitation in a geography, and then 281 million individual records. So I won't go through the differences and how you'll use them. You can read them here. But the one thing that I'll just point out is that the proximity data set, because it's behavioral, is really good at capturing change over time and then volume of activity, essentially how vibrant an area is. whereas the persona segmentation system is really good at capturing the people that live in that area. And for that reason, it's good for some of your more traditional retail site selection methodologies. And it's also really good for the marketing aspect, whether you're deploying into a Facebook audience, a Google audience, or even direct mailers. It is naturally hierarchical. So all of our segments have families that they level up into. Some of the segments can be regional. And so that's important. You can group up into those higher level families. And if you're a West Coast business moving into the East Coast, you can find those segment families on the East Coast and West Coast. It also helps, you know, there's a lot of segments. You don't have to split it up into so many different marketing campaigns. You can level it up into one generalized campaign. Okay, that's it. So we talked about data landscape, differences between persona and proximity, the data sources used, when you might use each. And then finally, we talked about the segment hierarchy. In the next video, we'll be going through how to discover your target segments using three different approaches. See you there.